I clearly know this is not evening. This is an afternoon. But come on, look at the vibe. Look at all of us. It looks as if we are ready to enter a nightclub or we've just stepped out of one. So I am clearly going to go by the feel of it, not by the time. Good evening, all of you, to yet another amazing Hangama original presented by Panorama Studios, Barcode. Now, every time that I have stepped onto this stage, it has been a celebration. The first time when we launched Hangama Play with a very, very blockbuster series that was damaged. It was so amazing, the star cast and everything. After that came another blockbuster, which was Hankar. And I am pleased to announce to all of you that Damaged and Hankar, two of the Hangama originals, have been nominated for the Indian Television Awards. So we can all hope for the best. And now, starting off with the third one, that is Barcode. And I'm personally already in love with the name because all of us know barcode is something that we see on the products. But over here, it clearly means something else. It's like bar. Code. It's the barcode, something of that sort. So without wasting any more time and without discussing too much about barcode already, I am going to call on stage the man who has been responsible for multiple innovations in the digital space, the COO of Hangama Digital Entertainment, Siddharth Roy. Please put your hands together for Siddharth Roy.
Friends of media, ladies and gentlemen, a very, very good evening to you on the back of Barcode. It's a pleasure for us to bring in our third original series to consumers. If you look at the overall journey over the last 3 to 4 months that we've been rolling out programs, we have gone out and told varied stories. And if you see the story and the narrative that both Vignesh and Abhishek have put together, this is another one which is extremely different. And we would believe that this kind of storytelling, this kind of narrative is something that Indian consumers and consumers out of South Asia have not necessarily seen. And we're extremely excited and happy to look at bringing something like this to Indian screens. In terms of the overall opportunity, because Hangama reaches out to 53 million consumers, both in India as well as South Asian audiences outside, we've gone about taking our originals and we've looked at various kinds of genres. We've gone out and built products across genres. You've seen a product that came in, which was our first, which was from crime. Then we did The Underbelly, which was Hankar, which was more drama. Now this drama series, which is Barcode, goes into extremely urban, uberish kind of a setting, and we believe the kind of stories that we're going to tell through Barcode is going to be extremely different and interesting to our users. You will also see us bringing in comedy, which is going to be the next release, and we're looking at regional in a big way to bring that to out to users as well. In terms of the overall consumer mix, because we cater to such large communities, we've gone out and built storytelling and narratives addressing smaller communities in question, being able to understand what is the kind of content that that consumer consumes, and then being able to target to that base. And that's something that we have gone out and we've attempted and we've seen consumers successfully consume Hangama's entertainment through the original space as well. To just give you a specific number, we've had roughly about 48 million episodic views of our two previous series that have happened over the last 3 to 4 months. And we are extremely committed and we believe Barcode is going to be another path-breaking product from Hangama, which we're going to put out there. And we're really looking eagerly for consumers to give us feedback on this offering. Thank you.
Thank you so much. I think there is a very important person who is not with us over here right now, but we do have a message from him for all of you. So can you please play the message?
A very good afternoon to all of you, my friends, and thank you for taking the time out to being with us. I'm sorry I couldn't be here in person, but nothing could be more exciting than what we are about to launch today. As my colleague Siddharth would have already shared with you, the success we've had to our originals has been absolutely fabulous. The kind of feedback we've received from our audiences and our consumers has encouraged us to tell more and more interesting stories. And that is what brings us today to the launch of our most exciting show, Barcode, set in upscale Mumbai nightlife. But we believe this is going to be a show that will resonate with audiences across the world, because ultimately, it is about friendship, it is about relationships, and it is about that bad word, ego. I'd like to welcome the wonderful cast of Akshay, Parina, Simran, and Karan, and our wonderful partners, Abhishek and Vignesh of Panorama Studios, along with my colleague, Sanjeev Lamba. Hungama and Panorama worked as a wonderful team in bringing this very exciting show, and we believe that it is something that all users of Hungama Play and our extended distribution partners are going to be looking forward to and be enjoying. Without much ado, let me now request my colleagues to tee this up. I hope you all enjoy watching this as much as we have enjoyed making it for you. Hungama hone do, guys.
Yeah, hungama hone do. And the thing that Neeraj was talking about, watching, we are all going to witness the trailer of Barcode. So can we please play the trailer of Barcode? What a star cast and what a power-packed trailer. Can we please play the trailer one more time? Do you guys want to see it one more time? ये ना नाइट क्लब से रशियन लड़कों की मोनोपोली मुझे खत्म करनी आई डोंट नो व्हाई इट्स अ सिनोनिम नाइट क्लब रशियन गर्ल्स लाइक दैट बट दैट्स माय पर्सनल एजेंडा मूविंग फॉरवर्ड आई एम गोइंग टू कॉल ऑन स्टेज सिद्धार्थ रॉय मिस्टर संजीव लांबा अभिषेक पाठक एंड विग्नेश शेट्टी कैन वी हैव द अमेजिंग पीपल हु आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर सच एन अमेजिंग प्रोडक्ट दैट वी आर सीइंग राइट नाउ ऑन स्टेज प्लीज Firstly, congratulations to all of you. Everything about Barcode looks so exciting, from the poster to the trailer, and I'm sure everything else that we're going to witness on Hungama Play as well. But Sanjeev, starting off with you, what, like right now, everything that we are seeing is already so polished, it's so exciting, and we know that there is something really, really, really amazing out there. But when you saw the raw product, what is it that you really liked about it, and what is it that got you hooked onto it?
First of all, thank you all for being here. This has been a journey of over a year. Actually, it started with Abhishek's dad, Kumarji, and I had occasion to work earlier, and I knew that he was looking at doing a digital series, and I approached them. And I still remember Abhishek and Vignesh, we met at Starbucks in Juhu, and we had a long chat about this show that they wanted to do. And there were things that I instantly liked about it. First of all, it was a kind of story that had not been told in the digital sort of area earlier. The uber rich, nightclub, nightlife, friends, drama, combined with the setting of, you know, running a nightclub, Russian girls, drugs, police, and everything like that. So that was very, very interesting. But more specifically, I have great respect for Abhishek's producing chops. He's made some wonderful movies. And I knew that he would bring a lot of production passion. And most importantly, I think Vignesh had been living with this story. And he knew how to tell it. He knew that for the people who actually go to the nightclubs, it had to feel natural and good. And for the people who don't go to nightclubs, it had to feel like a wonderful world. And that balance is sometimes tricky. But he knew how to tell this story. And as the story came together and as the wonderful cast came together, I think it was one of the easiest decisions to be able to go out and say, let's go and make this.
And that is how we got Barcode. How long have you lived with this? Because you've written it and you've directed it. How long have you lived with Barcode? How many years?
I'll be honest with you. I have been clubbing for the longest time. You know, so that's probably 20 years since I made Barcode. So for me, it's very organic. I think...
You wrote the first draft on the tissue paper of a nightclub.
Sorry, come again?
You wrote the first...
I might have. I have no recollection of that, but I might have. So for me, this has been... the world, what you're seeing in the trailer, has been part of my life for 20 years. So this is a world I know very well. It comes very organic for me. So I do this every Saturday, even till today. So for me, it was just organic, and it just all came together. The stories came from there. I have friends in the nightclub business. I've known a lot of people from this world. So it all just came together well.
Thank you so much. How was it for you to enter the whole web series thing? We all know that you've been a part of such amazing films. You've given us all such amazing blockbusters. But to enter the web series zone, how was it? And why do you think is it viable?
I think so entering a web space for any other format we make or to tell a story is not actually called. It's a progression of cinema. When he came with Barcode idea, I think it was a great story to tell. So it was a little different than what we normally make in films. A little experimental, little upbeat, little something which people are not ready to watch. So we chose, like, let's make it. And it was obviously a great writing, and finally the audience was changing themselves to watch web shows. People at their own convenience can sit and watch something they like. So it was called that we took, and we got made this show, Roy.
That, you know, I love this whole, this change that has come into our society. I remember every time I came back home, I would see my mother hooked onto the television, waiting for another episode. But now she is actually the person who waits for all of these web series, and she's the one who enjoys it way more than I do, on her own convenience, playing it as and when she wants. So I am totally in love with this change. What do you think about the change that web series have brought and the kind of excitement that audiences have been showing for web series?
So actually, Vadia, the first and foremost is the medium itself. I think the medium lends to all of this. Television is a one-to-many. There's content that's being made for a certain set of audiences, and that tends to be of a specific type of content being made available. I believe with the digital space, the big change is that it's a one-to-one. I mean, today as a consumer, I pick and choose the genre and the kind of content I want to consume. And I think that is one of the biggest liberation that's happened, where today there's content that's being made for various sets of consumers and communities and various genres of content. And in that, that's also the reason why for Hangama, it's not about only doing drama, only doing crime, only doing comedy. It's about great stories and great narratives. And here, I believe what we're putting out through Barcode to the user, we sincerely, as a team, have put in that effort to go out and put together a product that we genuinely believe there will be a set of consumers that will want to come and consume this for the storytelling and the narrative that's being put out to them.
Actually, there's something that I have noticed with all the Hangama originals that I've seen on Hangama Play, be it Damaged, be it Hankar, be it Barcode now. Everywhere you can see that gray shade of human nature, and that is something that I personally have. And that's why I would like to see it in everything that I see. So that is something that is constant with all the Hangama originals. So guys, without wasting any more time, do we want to call the star cast? Yeah? So let's call the star cast on stage. People who need no introduction. Karan Vahi, Akshay Oberoi, Pareena Chopra, and Simran Kaur Mundi. Can we have a huge round of applause for all... All right, so Karan, starting off with you. You know, I need to tell you something. They say that, you know, your first impression of a person is actually your last impression. And I remember him from the remix days. And he was this really good boy over there amidst all the bad people. And then you see him doing all these roles of Grey Shade. And every time I see a trailer where Karan Vahi does a role of Grey Shade, I tell myself, "Achha ladka bigad gaya bichara." I still have that good boy image. What is, you know, does this happen to you very often?
I was told women dig bad boys. So I just became one. I'm just glad I'm not the anchor tonight. But
Yeah, we see him doing that even more often.
I was actually, you know, wondering. I was like, do they have an anchor or should I only like go today? But yeah, it's fun. Like, you know, I think it's always fun to work on different things that you keep, you know, evaluating yourself. For the longest time, I wanted to do something negative or grey. And everyone used to tell me that, "Arre, tu itna cute sa bachcha hai.
Exactly.
Tu, tujh pe suit nahin karega." And unfortunately, what happens is a lot of times, the way you look, especially in our country, people perceive you for characters in that only that way only. So I'm glad that people are actually seeing the bad boy in me. Gives me more opportunities and gives me, you know, more variations in the kind of work I do.
I mean, seriously, look at him over there. Look at the forehead, the
frown. Do I look like a bad boy there?
You do look like a very, very bad boy.
I think I look sexy.
Parina.
Yes.
So, firstly, how was your experience working with the man behind you, Vignesh? 20 years in a nightclub, he knew every single thing the way it's supposed to. How finicky was he with everything?
Say good things, he'll edit you.
Guys,
it's still not on.
Like, my co-actors know, like, what we're going to say about our director. Like, we all have discussed for so long that we've been talking about, you know, how good he is with his own product. For him, it's a baby, right? Barcode is something very close to him. And he cannot at any point do anything wrong, be it any character, be it Karan, Simran, Akshay, mine, anybody, or be it other characters also. He's worked so hard with me, and whereas there was a lot of workshops taken before this series was started, and I know, like, one sentence also I'll say, and sir would be like, no, Parina, we can do this in a better way. And I'm like, yes, we can, and I'm a new artist. So, and he's worked really hard with me, especially for him and I, especially in the show, it's the first thing. For me, coming here and doing this also feels very special. And I'm very happy to be part of Barcode. And yep.
And I'm sure it's going to, you know, your entire tenure and every single thing is going to go a very, very long way, because it is Barcode, something that is so exciting and something that already looks so amazing. Yes. Akshay. You have had a legacy of such amazing films and then web series, and there are so many projects that are coming up as far as, you know, your career is concerned. In this entire pool of projects and everything, web series, what does that give to you? What is that for you?
Well, I think this web space is a very exciting space for everyone, because a lot of young actors and directors, writers are getting a platform that they perhaps would not have gotten before. I think a talent like Vignesh Shetty getting to do a web series is, I'm sure Vignesh will be making several feature films for you guys to all see soon. Maybe Abhishek Pathak will be part of them, because he's a very talented guy. But to get a leg up, to get that platform, you know, to
he's
see
like,
his
that's
work,
obvious.
To see his work shine, this web series space is a great space. And as far as, you know, what it means to me is that it gives you it's a way to explore, because a lot of what I like to do, I'm not really ever chasing stardom, to be really honest with you. That's not something I ever set out to do. I always wanted to be the best possible actor I could be. And sometimes in films, you get kind of pigeonholed into certain characters and certain playing something a certain way. And directors also want it in a certain way. In the web space, there is much more creative freedom. So there's room to experiment, there are room to try things. Language is not a concern. Nobody comes to you and says, "Arey yaar, Hindi mein bolo, ya Angrezi mein bolo." It's much more open. And you can do many things that perhaps somebody would be like, "Nahi yaar, hamari audience isko pasand nahi karegi." You know, like, what if I played it this way? Nahi, ye zyada subtle ho gaya, logon ko samajh mein nahi aayega. So those restrictions are no longer there in this space. And I think that the future of Bollywood or our Hindi film industry or Hindi industry in general it looks a lot more promising to me when you have young talents like Vignesh Shetty and other people who are making web series coming out and doing it by the numbers, because now it'll be merit. It'll be the people who are actually good at their job and know their craft that get that next bump up.
Right. Simran, how was it working with the three present over here? How was it? What was the on-set chemistry with all of them like?
So Vahi, I knew from before, and Akshay and Parina, however, I've met on set, and I think we all share a very good working relationship, and during this process of working together, we've also formed a very good bond of friendship, and I wanted to add one thing, especially for Vahi, because Akshay, we've seen him act before in several films, and we know, you know, like the kind of roles that he does. But Vahi, however, like you mentioned, is in this very cute chocolate boy image, and breaking that barrier and actually being able to do this role and play Vicky to its and give complete justice. I think hats off to him. He's done a brilliant job at it, and it's I think a give and take, like for me, you know, especially. So I had most of my scenes are coming to Akshay. Most of my scenes were with Akshay, and I believe as an actor, he gave me enough for me to respond to him. Because if you have a good actor that you work with, and if that comfort and that thing is there, and somewhere I do believe that my performance in this has really improved because of Akshay and the way he gave me the dialogues and the way I reacted to them. So it's been a great experience overall, and the most special mention I want to give is to our director Vignesh Shetty. I cannot. He's the toughest taskmaster. He's just brilliant. I mean, it was amazing working with him. And if you work with him once, you will know exactly what we've gone through. And I do wish you work with him, all of you.
I'm just going to interrupt for 1 second. The trailer you guys just watched, there's a slight, small voiceover of mine in the start of it, which maybe, 40 seconds? And I did 44 takes of that in the dubbing studio until the man was in, like, I would be like, "Arey, ho gaya yaar, phaad diya maine," and I'd walk out of the dubbing studio, and he'd look at me and say, actually, I feel that one word. No, can we do it one more time? So I was like, okay. And with him, you can't argue. And I don't want to get into a space where I'm arguing with him, because he knows what he wants and he's right. So I would go back in. And when I left, I asked, I checked, how many takes did I do? It's 44 takes. Either that means I'm awful or it means like he's insane.
He is too good.
He's crazy.
I think we should definitely not go by face value, because just look at him. Bhola bhala chehra. 44 takes. All of them are lying, right? I should go by the face value.
Are you
sure?
That's
what we all did. We went by face value.
No, we should ask him. We should ask him, are you sure you want to release it today? Or there's some
edit left? You want to pull it off the platform? You want to do degrading again?
No, we are all set no matter what you guys say. Acha, usually jab koi film ki shooting hoti hai, jab koi web series ki shooting hoti hai, it's either on the streets of Mumbai, you're going to the slums, or you're going on this, you know, on the road, talking to people. Over here, the scene is completely, it's sober, firstly, it's sober. And you are in the nightclubs. So how, like, did you guys ever try to calculate the hours spent in a nightclub just for this web series? Like, how often did you guys actually go to nightclubs? And was your workshop in the nightclub?
No. It was in the Panorama.
I think a couple of us grew up in a generation when nightclubs were very popular. And I mean, I'm speaking for some people here. But I'm mostly Wahi, because I feel like we have a similar sort of, I mean, he was in Delhi, I was in Bombay. But I think that people of this generation have seen a lot of nightclubs. I don't think that was a necessary part of it, because we have seen it already. So that's just what I feel. I don't know if you guys.
True. So I'm going to open the platform for media Q&A. If anybody has a question, please ask for the mic and go ahead.
Hello. Mera sawal Karan se. Hi, Karan.
Hi.
Rehman from ANI.
Hi, Rehman.
Personally, aapka kya thoughts hai digital ko leke, aur kitna grow kar raha hai, aur humne suna ki aage bhi aapki web series hai Hangama ke saath, uske bare mein thoda janna chahiye.
Kya baat kar rahe ho yaar?
I signed him already.
You didn't tell me. Nahin, but thank you, Rehman. Yaar, main primarily ek TV background se aata hu. Maine bahut television kiya hai. लाइफ में और यू नो पहले एक टेलीविजन होता था और फिल्म होती थी बीच में कुछ नहीं होता था एंड आई एम सो ग्लैड कि द वेब स्पेस हैज़ एक्चुअली गिवन सो मेनी एक्टर्स इफ आई एम स्पीकिंग फॉर माई सेल्फ मैं अगर अपने लिए बोलूँ तो द पोटेंशियल एंड द चांस टू डू सो मच मोर इतना कुछ हम जब टी वी में होते हैं हम यू नो आई एम नॉट गोना डीमेरिट इट बट हम हमेशा टेलीविजन एक्टर्स के मुँह से सुनते हैं कि यार कॉन्टेंट इतना कमाल नहीं है हम काम करते हैं करने के लिए तो जब वेब स्पेस बड़ा हो रहा था या यू नो वी स्टार्टेड आई थिंक ऑलमोस्ट अ ईयर एंड अ हाफ बैक एक डेढ़ साल पहले हमने बारकोड शुरू किया था तब वेब इतना ज़्यादा इंडिया में पॉपुलर हुआ नहीं था मासी तो आई थिंक एक प्लेटफॉर्म मिलता है अच्छा काम करने का एक प्लेटफॉर्म मिलता है जैसे अक्षय ने कहा कि कोई इश्यूज़ नहीं होते लैंग्वेज के कि आपको हिंदी में ही बात करनी है या इंग्लिश में ही बात करनी है या एक तरीका होता है जिससे हम बात करते हैं वो फ्रीडम मिलता है एंड आई थिंक फॉर एन एक्टर दैट्स द बेस्ट थिंग दैट यू कैन गेट बिकॉज योर जस्ट गोना बी अ कम्प्लीट एक्टर इफ़ यू ट्राई एंड डू थिंग्स यू नो विच आर डिफरेंट एंड इफ यू ट्राई टू इवॉल्व विद द थिंग्स दैट आर हैपनिंग तो आई थिंक मुझे आई एम रियली रियली ग्लैड एंड आई एम ग्रेटफुल कि मुझे ये प्लेटफॉर्म मिला है और आई होप आपकी बात सच हो जाए हंगामा सुन रहे हो तो प्लीज़ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट भेज देना एंड आई होप आई कीप डूइंग गुड स्टफ एंड आई कीप एंटरटेनिंग पीपल
जैसे भी आपने कहा कि कंटेंट ही किंग है वेब सीरीज़ को लेकर कहीं ना कहीं ये आपको लगता है कि वेब सीरीज़ में अनसेंसर कंटेंट होते हैं सेंसर नहीं होता है लेकिन कहीं ना कहीं न्यूडिटी दिखाने से व्यूअर्स और फैंस को भी डिसअपॉइंटेड होता है
सर वो डिपेंड करता है मतलब डिपेंड्स ऑन शो टू शो मैं अगर पर्सनली ये मेरा पर्सनल थॉट प्रोसेस है कि न्यूडिटी जहाँ ज़रूरी है वहाँ ज़रूरी है बिकॉज अगर मैं अपने आप को एक एक्टर बोलता हूँ तो मैं कुछ भी करने के लिए तैयार होना चाहिए इफ़ आई बिलीव इन द थॉट प्रोसेस अगर मैं बिलीव करता हूँ कि मैं स्मोक कर सकता हूँ ऑन कैमरा क्योंकि मेरे कैरेक्टर को स्मोकिंग दिखानी है या करनी चाहिए तो आई थिंक व्हेन दैट न्यूडिटी क्लॉज स्पेशली कम्स इन इंडिया वी ओवर थिंक इट बट पर्सन टू पर्सन है मेरा पर्सनली मानना यह है कि टिल द टाइम इट्स नॉट जस्ट फॉर द हैक ऑफ इट It's good. Yes, there are a lot of content out there जो primarily focus उस पर करते हैं but वो उनका you know thought process है उस पर मैं ना तो रोक टोक कर सकता हूँ ना मैं कुछ comment करना चाहूँगा
अब अपने friend ऋत्विक की web series XXX अल्ट बालाजी की वो देखी है आपने
मैंने यार बालाजी की XXX देखी नहीं है but वो अगर एक show का नाम ही XXX है so I think you already know what they're trying to sell अब मैं जब वो शो देखूंगा तो मैं कमेंट कर पाऊंगा कि वो कितना जायज है और कितना नहीं है
थैंक यू सो मच
दैट्स इट
कैन यू प्लीज प्ले द ट्रेलर अगेन
ऑफ कोर्स वी कैन वी
कैन वी लाइक प्लीज सी द ट्रेलर
काफी डिफरेंट क्वेश्चन था वो
Can you come on all our press conference?
Yeah, we'll Everywhere invite we go. You to every press conference.
We really love you. Yeah.
Please put your hands together. That is a Hangama original presented by Panorama Studios, available on Hangama Play. And before we move towards the photo op, Vignesh, I have this one small question for you. I really want to know if I decoded the barcode thing earlier correctly. It is bar separate, code separate. What is it about barcode? What's the meaning of barcode over here? Because we all know it's thing that we see on the product.
You're right, but in the context of what the show is and what the story is, it's a code of conduct that that the hotel association, the guys who monitor business ethics or business practices in any part of the world, who kind of advise on a code of conduct to be followed. Because these two guys go berserk in the show. Their characters go berserk. They do all the things they're not supposed to do. So that's the reason why the title came into place, because we had to signify why, what is the hook of the story, and that was barcode.
Thank you. Thank you. And I'm totally in love with that title. It's just...
Thank you.
When it's my nightclub, it's barcode. It's really nice. So we're going to move towards the photo op. I request our entire crew to kindly be ready. We'll move towards the photo op. If anybody wants to ask a question, we are actually going to go towards the media interaction. So we're going to open the stage for photo op, right?
Before we leave, I would like to call...
this is the first one.
I want to call all the people who made this possible for me, my HODs, my editors, my sound designer, my background music composer, my casting directors, my VFX supervisor. All these guys over the last 2 years worked day in, day out to make this happen. Production, my team, Sanjeev Joshi, Pragya, all of these guys who were with me as a pillar of strength for the last 1.5 years, and I thank you so much for all of that. I just request all my HODs, Arjun, Mahir, Vicky Sidana, Apurva, Josh, all of you guys, Sashwat, Ishan, all of you guys to please come on stage, please. Pragya, you too. Arjun, don't feel shy.
तकरीबन मुझे इट्स बीन लाइक अराउंड 2 साल हो गए
दो साल या
एटलीस्ट टू लाइक आई मेट विग्नेश अराउंड 2-2.5 years बैक मैं ऐसी मीटिंग के लिए गया था क्योंकि अभिषेक हमारे जो प्रोड्यूसर हैं वो मेरे दोस्त हैं तो मैं अभिषेक से बात कर रहा था उस टाइम पे कि यू नो अभिषेक वाज लाइक क्या कर रहा है तू, व्हाट्स हैपनिंग इन लाइफ एंड यू नो वर्क वाइज. आई वाज लाइक आई एम जस्ट फिगरिंग आउट यू नो अच्छा काम देख रहे हैं क्या है. सो ही सेड यू नो जस्ट कम, आई हैव समथिंग फॉर यू, आई डोंट नो इफ यू वांट टू डू इट बिकॉज इट्स फॉर द वेब, बट आप आइए, आप मेरे डायरेक्टर से मिल लो एक बार. सो आई जस्ट वेंट, मैं गया विघ्नेश से मिलने एंड आई जस्ट वेंट इन माई नॉर्मल घर का क्लोथ. मुझे था कि शायद मुझे सिर्फ मिलने के लिए बुलाया, मैं चला जाता हूँ. एंड द kind of क्लोथ्स दैट आई वॉज वेयरिंग एंड द kind of मूड प्रॉब्ली मैं जिस मूड में था उस टाइम पे, एक्चुअली टोल्ड आई वॉज टोल्ड लेटर ऑन बाई विघ्नेश कि ही गेव मी द शो बिकॉज ऑफ दैट, बिकॉज दैट्स द kind of थिंग्स जो मेरा कैरेक्टर विकी है वो शो में है. तो जब मैं बाकुट से जुड़ा था तो मैं उस टाइम पे एक्चुअली आई वाजंट डूइंग मच एक्टिंग वाइज, मैं बहुत एंकरिंग कर रहा था टेलीविजन पे. तो मेरे पास एक्टिंग का स्कोप था, टाइम था मेरे पास एक्टिंग को देने का. जब मैं बाकुट शूट कर रहा था, बिकॉज बाकुट हैज़ बीन शॉट एक्सटेंसिवली यू नो, बहुत टाइम 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 में हम ब्रेक्स में शूट कर रहे थे क्योंकि सबकी डेट्स मैनेज करनी थी. आई वॉज डूइंग सो मेनी थिंग्स टुगेदर. तो मैंने वही मैंने अभी किसी को इंटरव्यू में बोला कि एक सिमिलैरिटी जो मेरे और मेरे कैरेक्टर में जो मुझे ऐसा लगता है मुझे बेनिफिट हुआ ये था कि आई वाज वर्किंग टू मच, सो आई वाज वर्कड अप ऑल द टाइम. तो
मैं मतलब इवन व्हेन ही यूज्ड टू कम फॉर बारकोड शूट के लिए भी, दैट वाज आल्सो लाइक मुझे अब इसके बाद कहीं और जाना है, मुझे 7 बजे तक पहुँचना ही ये वाला खत्म करो. ही all the time like
so
busy.
I was working, so I think, but it's been a great experience. Bahut acha experience raha hai. You know, got to work with new people, got to do something new. Aur jab aapka kaam you know khatam ho jata hai, aap duniya ko dikhana chahte ho, you're always excited because jab aapko itna maza aata hai kaam karne mein na, to I think wo dikhta hai aur wo I'm sure dikhega.
And how was your experience working with Karan?
सो बिफोर ये वेब सीरीज बाहर आती और जिसपे मैंने काम अभी किया है, करण को मैं पहले से जानती हूँ, लाइक 2 साल और पहले से जानती हूँ. वी बी करण को सब जानते हैं, कौन करण को नहीं जानता, बात ये है.
करण सबका दोस्त है, बहुत दोस्त आदमी है.
नहीं, जब हम दोनों एक जिम में भी वर्कआउट करते हैं और हम लोग फ्रेंड्स भी हैं. एंड जैसे जिस दिन मुझे पता चला कि आई एम कास्टेड फॉर मिनास, मुझे पहले से पता था कि करण विक्की कर रहा है एंड अक्षय साहिल कर रहा है और देर इज़ वन अदर गर्ल सिमरन, शी इज़ प्लेइंग रिया. सो आई वॉज हैप्पी. यू नो, एक और अच्छा लगता है जब आप अपने एक दोस्त के साथ काम करते हैं, एक कंफर्ट लेवल और हो जाता है. और हम दोनों का रिलेशनशिप जो दिखाया गया है, विच इज़ 5 साल का लिविंग रिलेशनशिप है, उसके अंदर जो प्रॉब्लम्स आई हैं वो सब, विच इज़ वेरी नेचुरल जो होता है. तो सबसे मुझे लगता है मेरे लिए बहुत ईजी हो गया था टू वर्क अराउंड and work with Karan. So that was really like helpful because aise bhi scenes hain jo thoda sa main I think uncomfortable hoti karte hain, but that was like the demand from the script, so I worked it out.
Yaar maine ki aisa nahi hai ki maine parties nahi ki hain, but main na I think ab main us age se nikal thoda sa bada ho gaya hu ki main that I'll not call myself a party animal, क्योंकि you know usually क्या होता है जब आप एक एज ब्रैकेट होता है आपकी लाइफ में जब आप सिर्फ पार्टीज करते हो, क्योंकि you know आपका आपकी बॉडी भी गिव अप नहीं करती है. और आई थिंक इट्स ऑल्सो अ मेंटल थाट प्रोसेस. आई एम नॉट अ पार्टी एनिमल, आई एम पार्टी एनिमल, बट आई थिंक माई पार्टीज फ्रॉम क्लब्स हैव शिफ्टेड टू माई हाउस. तो मेरा जो घर है वो मेरे दोस्तों के लिए इट्स द प्लेस टू बी. आई विल कॉल इट देयर यू नो देयर सेफ जोन, देयर सेफ हाउस. तो हमारी अब पार्टीज आर नॉट अबाउट मैड म्यूजिक, इट्स अबाउट गुड कॉन्वर्सेशंस. नो, इट्स नॉट अबाउट लाइक, इट्स नॉट अबाउट यू नो कि हम गाने मतलब ऐसा फुल यू नो फुल वॉल्यूम पे
अपने कर रहे
हैं. हाँ, मतलब फुल वॉल्यूम पे, मतलब ऐसा कोई गाने मेरे घर पे नहीं चलते हैं. नाउ इट्स मोर अबाउट लाइक यू नो म्यूजिक चलता है, बातें होती हैं, कभी हम फिल्म्स देख रहे होते हैं, कभी हम कुछ ना कुछ करते रहते हैं. सो आई थिंक नो लॉन्गर अ पार्टी एनिमल, आई होप.
वेरी सीरियस क्वेश्चन टू बोथ ऑफ यू.
जी, यार आई थिंक मी टू. आई रियली रिस्पेक्ट द एंटायर एस्पेक्ट दैट पीपल आर एक्चुअली फाइनली कमिंग आउट.
This takes lot of courage also to like come out suddenly, and this has been started. और अब आई थिंक धीरे धीरे सब लोग बाहर आ रहे हैं. लाइक आई एम giving full support to the people who are coming up with this, but and hona bhi chahiye yaar, ek workplace kahi bhi ho, it has to be very much safe for both men and women to like work. Like ek apne ek mindset se banda aata hai kaam karne ki mujhe yahan kaam karne aaya to sirf kaam hona chahiye. I don't think ye sab cheeze bilkul bhi exist karni chahiye.
And I think it's not just one fraternity, it's in each and every fraternity. Yeah. It's just that hamara entertainment field bahut zyada aankhon mein aata hai, that's why the cases are more that we are seeing, but I completely support them, and I'm glad that there are people who are coming out and are being strong enough. To main sirf aur sirf logon se sirf yahi kehna chahta hu, especially people who rant a lot on the digital medium, ki agar koi insaan guy or a girl has come out and said something and has either supported the thought or has said that it's happened to me, please don't troll that person, ki kyunki it's sad that you know half the time people don't come out because they are scared that you know something like this
already
will happen.
Already unke saath hua hai, uske baad phir se ye sab karna.
So even nahi, main keh raha hu ki hua hai ya nahi hua hai, that the judiciary will take a decision, but if someone's trying to talk about something, let's not you know demean them in a certain way ki aap publicity ke liye kar rahe ho, because let the judiciary take their entire decision and then we'll see what actually is. But I am glad that it's happening and I support them. I completely am with them.
So you watching Big Boss?
I don't watch it yaar, mere se na matlab main batata hu kyun, main mera problem kya hai, I used to watch it a lot pehle, ab na life mein वैसे ही वक्त नहीं है इतना, और जो वक्त होता है ना मुझसे लड़ाइयाँ देखी नहीं जाती, मतलब आई डोंट अंडरस्टैंड वाई पीपल आर फाइटिंग एंड आई कम्प्लीटली अंडरस्टैंड द थॉट कि वॉट दे आर गोइंग थ्रू, वी डोंट गेट इट बिकॉज देर इन अ हाउस एंड फ्रस्ट्रेशन आर बिल्ट अप एंड वी सी द बेस्ट वन आवर, वी डोंट सी द 23 आवर्स. सो दैट्स वाई आई डोंट वॉच इट, बिकॉज मेरे बहुत सारे दोस्त हैं अंदर, तो मैं ना उन्हें सपोर्ट करता हूँ, बट आई थिंक परसेप्शंस बन जाती हैं, अगर आप कुछ देख लो ना तो आपको ऐसा लगता है यार ये ऐसा क्यों कर रहा है. सो आई दैट्स व्हाई आई डोंट वॉच.
थैंक यू सो मच.
थैंक यू.
थैंक यू गाइस. और
एक बहुत आ रहा है, नहीं वो दरवाजा बंद हो जाएगा, और वो सीन वैसा है कि क्लब में ना एक मिनट जब
प्राइसिंग का
पता, ये अभी एक मिनट ऐसे चलेगा सीन वैसा. बहुत बहुत दोनों का स्वागत है आपका इस कन्वर्जेशन में. ट्रेलर काफ़ी अमेजिंग लगा, तो किस तरह से शुरुआत इस बार को वेब सीरीज़ की आप दोनों से जानना चाहेंगे, कैसा एक्सपीरियंस रहा?
बहुत बढ़िया एक्सपीरियंस है. ये जो माध्यम है वेब सीरीज़ का, ये प्लेटफॉर्म हर जगह पहुंचता है, तो इसकी रीच बहुत बढ़िया है. फिल्मों में अक्सर क्या होता है कि आपने बहुत शिद्दत से फिल्म बनाई है लेकिन आपने उस ठीक तरह से मार्केटिंग नहीं की उसकी, और वीकेंड में इतने ही दिन मिलते हैं आपको पैसे कमाने के लिए, तो लोग आते नहीं. ये गारंटीड आईबॉल्स हैं, बिकॉज अगर लोगों को पता चला कि ये शो अच्छा है लाइक दैट फ्रॉम द ट्रेलर या मतलब वर्ड ऑफ माउथ से कि इट्स अ गुड शो, देखना चाहिए, इट्स देयर लाइफ लॉन्ग, आप कभी भी देख सकते हो. दैट्स द एक्साइटिंग पार्ट ऑफ अ प्लेटफॉर्म लाइक दिस.
आई थिंक ओवरऑल द एक्सपीरियंस वॉज फैंटास्टिक, एंड आई थिंक वेब सीरीज एक ऐसा जैसा उन्होंने बोला माध्यम है जहाँ ये बहुत ही अच्छा प्लस है कि देर इज़ नो रिस्ट्रिक्शन इन टर्म्स ऑफ सीइंग द फिल्म और द कॉन्टेंट फॉर दैट टाइम. बट इवन आई वॉन्ट टू एड टू दैट इज़ कि इसमें एज एन एक्टर ऑल्सो आपको काफ़ी कुछ वाइडर स्कोप मिल जाता है, स्पेशली फॉर समवन लाइक मी टू शोकेस अ टैलेंट एंड टू कम आउट एज नॉट जस्ट अ प्रीटी फेस बट ऑल्सो समवन हु कैन बी नोन एज एन एक्टर. सो अगर हम बारकोड की बात करें तो इसका जो रोल है वो काफ़ी चैलेंजिंग था मेरे लिए, बिकॉज वो मैं अगर ऐसी हूँ तो रिया बिल्कुल ऐसी है. सो इट वॉज अ कम्प्लीट ऑपोजिट ऑफ मी, एंड मुझे ये रोल करने में बहुत ही ज़्यादा मज़ा भी आया और उतना ही ज़्यादा डिफिकल्टी भी आई. सो ओवरऑल वॉज अ वेरी गुड एक्सपीरियंस.
आई थिंक इंडिया एक ऐसी कंट्री है ट्रेडिशनल और कल्चरल वाली, जहाँ जैसे वेब सीरीज के लिए मैं भी सवाल पूछना, न्यूडिटी की बात करें, इस तरह का न्यूडिटी दिखाना वेब सीरीज अनसेंसर तो होता ही है, कट नहीं होता, इस तरह दिखाना व्यूअर्स को डिसअपॉइंट करना, और क्या लगता है ओवरऑल ये सही है?
नहीं, मैं आपकी बात से सहमत नहीं हूँ, बिकॉज इट्स नॉट अ कल्चरल इशू, इट्स एन एज अप्रोप्रिएट इशू, एंड आई थिंक दैट इज़ एन इंटरनेशनल मैंडेट कि हम एक उम्र लगाते हैं पिक्चरों पे या वेब सीरीज़ पे या कुछ भी, कि इस उम्र के लोग देख सकते हैं ये नहीं देख सकते हैं, दैट इज़ पोलिटिकली डिसाइडेड बाय अ गवर्नमेंट, बाय गवर्नमेंट ऑर्गेनाइज
सेंसर बोर्ड. सो दैट इज़ नथिंग टू डू विद हमारी सभ्यता में ये लिखा है वो लिखा है. क्रिएटिव फ्रीडम है फॉर एन आर्टिस्ट, फॉर अ डायरेक्टर, फॉर अ राइटर, और होना भी चाहिए. और मुझे नहीं लगता कि उसको सेंसर करना चाहिए. एंड खासतौर पर इस माध्यम पर, बिकॉज ये माध्यम बना है इस कारण कि आप इसको, आप नेट न्यूट्रैलिटी को सेंसर नहीं कर सकते हैं. सो ये मेरी पर्सनल राय है. आई एम श्योर अदर पीपल हैव डिफरेंट ओपिनियंस ऑन द मैटर, बट आई फील एज लॉन्ग एज आप एज अप्रोप्रिएट, जैसे हंगामा की जिम्मेदारी ये है कि आप लिखो उस पर कि कौन सा एज ग्रुप इसको देख सकता है. एंड एज लॉन्ग एज दैट इज़ हैपनिंग देन दे आर बींग रिस्पॉन्सिबल. तो उसके आगे हम कुछ नहीं कर सकते, बिकॉज आर्टिस्ट डिजर्व अ सर्टेन अमाउंट ऑफ क्रिएटिव फ्रीडम. और अगर आपको अपनी स्टोरी बताने के लिए न्यूडिटी दिखानी है, ड्रग यूज़ दिखाना है, तो ये सभ्यता सबके साथ क्या लेना देना है. हम पिक्चरें ये नहीं सोच के बनाते कि सभ्यता के खिलाफ है या नहीं है. हम फिल्में बनाते हैं स्टोरीज जो ह्यूमन काइंड स्टोरीज है. So I don't agree with that.
जो एक real life scenario है basically वो दिखाते हैं. And I completely agree with him कि I think it is something कि it's very age appropriate.
One of your favorite web series recently we have seen?
यार मुझे Secret Games काफ़ी अच्छी लगी. मुझे
Inside Edge भी बहुत अच्छी है.
Inside Edge भी अच्छी. फिर एक TVF की थी Permanent Roommates
भी बहुत अच्छी है.
बहुत बढ़िया थी.
Very good.
एंड इट्स स्टिल अ नेसेंट थिंग. मतलब इसकी शुरुआत हो रही है इंडिया में अभी. फॉरेन में, अमेरिका में, लंदन में, यूके में वगैरह ये 20 साल से चीज़ें चल रहा है. तो वी आर एट द राइट टाइम, बिकॉज आप देखो यार, मेरी चार पांच ऐसी फिल्में हैं जो किसी ने थिएटर में नहीं देखी बट लोगों ने मोबाइल पे देखा. तो अगर मैं किसी के ऊबर में बैठूंगा तो बोलेगा सर आपकी पिज्ज़ा देखी थी मैंने. कहाँ देखी आपने? मोबाइल पे देखा मैंने. लाल रंग देखी या काला घटी जो भी. तो इसका क्या मतलब है कि आज की डेट में लोग इंडिया में बैठ करके मोबाइल, जियो के कारण या वोडाफोन के कारण देख रहे हैं मोबाइल पे. तो मुझे लगता है भविष्य यही है. सो इट्स एक्सट्रीमली एक्साइटिंग.
फिल्म्स आई थिंक विल इवेंचुअली बिकम मोर ऑफ एन एक्सपीरियंशियल थिंग,
सिनेमैटिक
एक्सपीरियंस, बिग स्क्रीन. बट देन आई थिंक कॉन्टेंट राइट नाउ सबसे ज्यादा कंज्यूम आपके मोबाइल पे ही हो रहा है. 24/7 आप फोन पे हो, जो भी देख रहे हो.
मैं खुद ही करता हूं यार. मैं फिल्में कम देखता हूं और YouTube पे कुछ चल रहा है तो वो देख लेता हूं.
इट्स वेरी कॉमन
एंड इट्स ग्रेट बिकॉज यू कैन एंगेज फॉर हाउएवर लॉन्ग यू वांट. अगर आपने वेब सीरीज स्टार्ट किया और आपको एक एपिसोड देख रहे हैं या दो एपिसोड देख रहे हैं, बाद में बाकी का देखना है या नहीं देखना है तो आपके हाथ में. इट्स एन इंटरेस्टिंग.
वेब सीरीज की बात करें, व्यूअर्स का ये भी कहना है कि जब वेब सीरीज देखते हैं तो सेकंडों में जो एड्स आते हैं वो बाद में एड्स आना वो भी कहीं ना कहीं परेशान.
प्लेटफॉर्म के ऊपर निर्भर करता है. लाइक ऑल्ड बालाजी, वूट, हंगामा, नेटफ्लिक्स, ये आपको एड्स नहीं दिखाते.
अमेज़न नहीं दिखाता.
क्योंकि आप सब्सक्राइब कर रहे हो. दे सब्सक्रिप्शन बेस्ड मॉडल्स. तो फॉर दैट यू कैनॉट हैव एडवर्टाइजिंग. YouTube, yes, but YouTube आप फ्री में देख रहे हो तो ये इसके ट्रेड ऑफ्स हैं. तो एज अ कंज्यूमर यू हैव टू डिसाइड कि आपको क्या पसंद है, कि आप एड्स देख लोगे या आप नहीं पसंद करते तो आप प्लेटफॉर्म पे जाओगे.
अब बहुत ही सीरियस सवाल है आपको. व्हाट यू से अबाउट द ट्रेंड व्हिच इज गोइंग ऑन #MeToo. लोग बात कर रहे हैं कि अपने अपनी राय रखने हैं, अपने जो केसेस हम देख रहे हैं बॉलीवुड में जो उठते आ रहे हैं डे बाई डे, क्या कहना चाहेंगे आप दोनों से?
आई एम वेरी हैप्पी दैट दिस इज हैपनिंग पर्सनली, बिकॉज मुझे लगता है कि दिस इज द इंडिया आई वॉन्ट टू लिव इन. जो सेक्शन 377 के बाद जो चेंजेस आए हैं, और मुझे लगता है अभी औरत भी ज़्यादा प्रोटेक्टेड और सेफ फील करेंगी इसके बाद. ऑफ कोर्स यू हैव टू डिसाइड कि नॉट एवरीथिंग इज़ मीटू. मतलब आप हर एक चीज़ को मीटू के कैटेगरी में नहीं डाल सकते. कभी कभार रिश्ते ख़राब हो जाते हैं, टॉक्सिक हो जाते हैं. इसका ये नहीं मतलब कि किसी का वो हुआ है या बलात्कार हुआ है. बट आई एम वेरी हैप्पी दैट एटलीस्ट देर इज़ अ स्टैंड पीपल आर टेकिंग एंड इसकी चर्चा हो रही है और ये बंद कमरों में बातें नहीं चल रही हैं. And I mean, it's a great time to live in India.
And also, I feel it's this Me Too movement is not just restricted to women. It's also for men. It is for everyone. It's not based on gender. किसी के साथ भी अगर ऐसा कुछ हुआ है तो वो गलत है. और अगर हुआ है और अगर कोई बाहर आकर उसके बारे में बात कर रहा है and genuinely अगर ऐसा हुआ है, then I think it takes a lot of courage and a lot of guts to do it. And hats off कि वो ये कर रहे हैं और एक movement है. And I think it's really good.
Thank you so much for talking to me.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Please come.